Cripple Oranji here. To celebrate the movie Star Wars: The Last Jedi, I'm gonna make my very own lightsaber. With Star Wars Episode 8 just around the corner, I wanted to make my very own lightsaber so I can take it with me when I see the movie at the cinema. This project will involve lots of soldering and wiring, but other than that, it's pretty straightforward. So, let's begin! For this project, I'll be using a replica Graflex flash gun. It's a special kit made for building a lightsaber, just like the one used by Rey in the movies. It has all the proper cutout holes and all the parts for making the different versions of the saber. For the electronics, I'll be using a soundboard for the sound effects and lights. Besides controlling the light effects and sounds, this board has sensors to detect swings and crashes so the proper sounds are played. To hold everything together, I'll be using a 3D printed chassis. It is designed to hold everything together and fits the handle perfectly. Like I said before, most of this build is soldering. Lots of soldering. I started with cutting a bunch of silicone wire and tinning them. I also tinned any other parts that would be soldered. Once the tinning was done, I started with the main LED. This is the part that will light up the blade. It is made of three LEDs, two colored and one white. The white is for the flash, when the saber hits something. To control the current sent to the LEDs, I needed to add resistors. The amount a resistor can resist is measured in ohms. Each LED needs to be individually wired to a resistor. This needs to be done because different color LEDs have different power requirements. For my build and LED type, I used 0.47 ohm resistors for the two blue LEDs and a 1 ohm resistor for the white LED. The LEDs were then placed into a copper housing. This is like a heat sink for the LEDs because they can get very hot. I connected everything to a breadboard to test it to make sure everything works. This soundboard is already loaded with sound files on the SD card, so you don't need code. Now that everything works, I need to make it fit into this. For the chassis, I started snapping the board speakers and power plug in place and soldered those. The last part was to connect the LED wires and switch wires. One final test to make sure everything lights up. All that is left to assemble the grips and outside buttons and put in the blade tube. That's it, all done. Now I have my very own lightsaber for when I go watch The Last Jedi. There are a few things that I will change for this project in the future, but for now, I'm super happy with it. If you like this video, please give me a like. And for a reminder of future videos, subscribe to my channel, Purple Oranji, and click the little bell icon. Also, check out my other videos. That's all for now. May the Force be with you. See you next time. Bye.